all. But the school was a shaping experience because led by a very inspiring headmaster. And then we moved on to both Loyola College, where you had to do a pre-university course, a very fine college. So I can recall these things very well. I did history. Chidambaram went on to the Presidency College to do statistics. And then I did my MA in Presidency College and went on later to do a journalism course at Columbia University. That sort of, I mean, I merely cataloged the years, but through this, you understand the need, I think, for two things. One is quality of education is important, along with the all-rounded education. But access is also important, and in the Christian College School of those days, as well as Loyola College, you met people from all walks of life and sort of became sensitive to different social requirements, backgrounds and so on, and also people from all religions and castes and cultural backgrounds. We got quite a good exposure to the magnificent diversity that is India in both high school and college. And I went largely to Christian schools, I mean, only to Christian schools and the college as well, till I went to Presidency College and later Columbia University. And they were very good, whether it was a Catholic school like Rosary Matriculation School or a Protestant school like Madras Christian College High School, a Jesuit College. They were excellent and no discrimination. Nothing suggesting narrow-mindedness, and it was tremendous. It was a tremendous experience, and I think you were assured quality, but these schools also brought in diversity. They were not in that sense, quote, elitist, none of them. And Loyola College, with which I kept in close touch, as well as the Madras Christian College High School, Loyola College in particular has improved, made progress in bringing more diversity, providing opportunities for people who are from disadvantaged backgrounds, deprived backgrounds, more than in my days. This is something I'm very happy about, because they're built on this. Because the whole point is, I think in all intellectual endeavor, there's a tension between a commitment to quality. You want to be world class, you want to be there, out there, and opening your gates wide to society, to people from all backgrounds. It's very hard, easy to say it in on paper, but very hard to do it in practice. How do you provide equal opportunity or compensatory opportunities for those who have been socially and historically denied the opportunity to study? People who are the first graduates in their family, for example, or want to become. That